What's up, YouTube? Welcome to the Strength Core. My name is Sean Ollie. I'm a competitive powerlifter and strength coach, and welcome to another video. Okay, so last video was my meet video. I kind of went and showed you guys like a nice little montage of everything that went down, talked a little bit about at the end of the video how I felt about the meet, what my thoughts were. And in today's video, we're back to training. So I've actually started training. Today is Saturday, June 24th. I started back training on Tuesday. It feels really good because like after meets, I'm able to kind of pull back, look at everything through like a scope, like a macro scope, and see exactly where it is that I'm headed, what I want to do. And it's nice to just kind of reset training and then start the building process all over again. And with that being said, I like to have kind of something symbolic whenever like I'm starting a new macro cycle, like to just say, okay, this is fresh, this is brand new. And what better way to do that than to spend money unnecessarily on another singlet from GBT. Now, the singlet I wore for regionals, I love that. The Miami Vice is, that's probably my favorite singlet. And I don't see another singlet topping that, at least for a while, not that I can conceptualize. But for me, I like wearing my singlet on Saturdays. I feel like it signifies, okay, I'm in here, I'm in competition mode, I'm really getting myself ready for like competing. So it's nice to kind of like have different singlets to wear so that way I don't just like wear it out super fast. So to symbolize the start of like a new program or a new macro cycle and kind of rebuilding, I went ahead and purchased this was the bread singlet that came out. So it's like black and red. I have had this for weeks. Actually, it might be months. I wanted to not open this until my meet was completed and everything had been done in the Miami Vice singlet, which by the way, I got so many props on. Like I'm gonna just put on the screen a few of like just the announcing, the commentating where I was just oozing drippage.
It's also looking very, very, very fresh. Impressive. On the platform. It's got the matching socks, the matching shoes, the better brand singlet. My man is cooking up with the fit today. If only they gave out superlatives for best dressed lifter of the day. I think that Sean would be the clear winner of that.
We've got Sean back on platform two. First attempt bench 170 kilos. This is our best dressed fella of the meet.
Sean Otley, best dressed. Let's see what best dressed Sean Otley has on platform two. The socks match the shoes and they match the singlet.
But this color scheme, yeah.
Miami Vice.
I love the neon.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I mean, what can I say? I bring some swag to the platform. And now it's time to get the bread. So I already exchanged out my laces, as you saw in like the little montage I did. I put some varsity red laces to match the red, and you see the red and black with the red and white, y'all. Listen, if there's one thing I'm gonna do is be drippy, all right? Some of y'all like might be like, oh, Sean, it's powerlifting, it's not that serious. Look, you look good, you lift good, and I'm a proponent of that. I really do believe in that. With that being said, let's open this up because I'm also curious to see what number I got, because each one of these is like individual, so it comes with like a jersey number or a singlet number, whatever you wanna call it. So I'm interested to see what my number is. All right, open that up. Good packaging as always. Made for lifters, by lifters. That's what's up. Woo, the quality. It just feels such high quality. I got another 3-digit number, right? I think my other one is 432 or something like that. This one, ooh, this is fresh. 383. 383 is pretty fresh. I'm not gonna lie, like 383 is fresh. That's a fresh number, so I'm not mad at it, you know what I'm saying? I really wish I had a 2-digit number, but you know, you beggars can't be choosers, right? Okay, yeah. This, with this, with these? Oh, I don't know if I've ever mentioned this, and I probably have. I've made like almost 500 videos or something like that. Black and red is my favorite color combination. So to have this singlet with those sneakers with my own logo? Yeah. This is gonna be a good training cycle. This is gonna be a fire training cycle. Anyway, okay, I'm doing a lot of talking. Let's get out of here, get to the gym. I'm gonna get some of these lifts in here. And then I'm gonna give you guys in today's video kind of my outlook of some of the things that I want to accomplish. Last video, I talked about like the meet and like how everything kind of culminated and what I did leading up to it. I gave a little bit of like outlook as to what I want to do, but in this video at the end, I'm going to just kind of give you guys a quick rundown of some of the goals that I currently have and what I want to do for the future. So without further ado, I got to come up with a good transition though. I feel like I've been just reusing the same transitions and it's getting boring. So I know one. Okay, so we're gonna give this a try, right? This new transition. So it's supposed to work. I saw a video on it. It's supposed to spin and then be in the next location. So I guess it's supposed to look something like this. Okay, so I don't know how that looked, but hopefully it looked decent. So in the gym, listen, this fit is about to go crazy. But what I think I'm gonna do first is I'm going to get myself warmed up. Maybe show some clips of that. I don't know. I really have no idea how I'm gonna record this, but once I get like warmed up and everything, I get the full fit on, we're gonna step over to the mirror so we can really appreciate, you know what I'm saying, the drippage that is going on today. Like bro, I might, the socks, the white, I don't know if I'm feeling. I think I could have gone with some black socks, but I am mad at this. GBT really be going off with the singlets. Whenever the next one drops, I'd probably buy that shit too. But okay, let's go ahead. I'm gonna get into the zone. Let's do what we came to do here. We wanted to look drippy, but we also want to lift some weight, so let's do that. Okay, so just finished squatting. Feels pretty good. One little change that I made, and I started implementing this on Thursday on my secondary squat. Oh my god, I cannot talk. My secondary squat day. Instead of going ring finger on the ring when I squat, I'm gonna go middle finger. It kind of allows me to let the bar sit a little more in the palm of my hand. Because what tends to happen when I go down into the bottom of the squat, my wrist kind of rotates, and it was putting a lot of stress on my wrist. So I'm gonna just move one finger in. It feels good. And I think maybe that's gonna be good. Maybe like I'm eventually gonna have to move out a little more, but I just wanna start with a finger because it feels good. It doesn't feel too different, except on my wrist. Like it doesn't feel different anywhere else. And I'm just kind of really make sure I maintain that good shelf, but it feels good. So I'm gonna stick with it. But 452 pounds for a triple, pretty happy with that. That is pretty good considering, you know, just had my meet last week and I'm still projected right now. If I increase how I normally do and everything works to plan, I should actually hit a PR at the end of this block, like a small one. But hey, I celebrate every PR, whether it's a pound, 10 pounds, 20 pounds, they're all the same to me. So I think that's really important in powerlifting, is you get so caught up in just our PR singles that like doubles, triples, PRs on accessory work, we kind of just don't really give that any credit. And I think that that's just a surefire way for you to burn out and not really appreciate the journey. I think you have to not just look at your main lifts for a single, look at your accessory work, look at your movements that aren't comp specific, like Larson's or tempos. Like PRing those is important too. But anyways, did some back downs with 350 pounds. That moved really easy. I was really in groove with those. So everything's feeling good, feeling healthy. Not feeling fatigued. I will say I forgot my other knee sleeves, so I'm not gonna use these heavy duty ones for belt squat. I'm gonna try and go sleeveless, which I haven't done in a very long time, but we'll see. I got the rest of the workout to do. I'm gonna refuel, rehydrate a little bit, and we got bench press, so let's get to that. That should be very, very easy today. Also, really quickly, so I bought this little, like, I don't know if you can see it, like this little like whey protein, like it's a little thing, it's a little bottle that I keep like my second dosage of pre-workout in. Well, pre-workout and a little bit of Catalyst for hydration. And so usually after squats, where I'm sweating kind of the most, I'll go ahead and usually have like a Gatorade to pour this into, but I forgot to bring an extra one. So I'm just gonna dry scoop this with the electrolytes I already have in here. So wish me luck, I haven't dry scooped anything in a long time. So I hope this goes well and I don't choke. Not great. So what happened is, for whatever reason, when I pour it into my mouth, it all formed into one giant ball, and I ended up just drinking a ball of pre-workout powder. So yeah, we're not gonna dry scoop anymore. Like, that's why I stopped doing it. It's never enjoyable for me. But hey, we got our second dosage of pre-workout and hydration, and so I guess, you know, anything for the games, right? This should work. Okay, let's get a little closer. Okay, so just finished bench pressing. Bench feels amazing right now. Like, yes, I didn't get the 430 pounds I wanted at the meet, but one, to the average person, if anybody asks me what I'm benching right now, I'm gonna say 430 pounds. Now, to the powerlifters, I'll maybe explain it if the conversation is that deep. If not, I might just say like 407 or something. But bench feels really good, and I do think that 430 pounds I missed, I'm gonna blow that shit up, like, probably, definitely by the end of this training cycle. But I don't think I'm blowing up 430 for a triple or a double or anything like that. But in a few months, I think I definitely will at least hit that for a single, and it'd be really fast and really efficient, or maybe even add, you know, 2.5 to 5 kilos to that. That'd be kind of dope. But as for today, bench feels really good. I think I kind of went back a little bit to not my older technique, but just kind of making sure the pressure of the bar is on the outside of my hand. That's really important, especially when you're somebody who, like, although I have long arms and not the best arch, I do bench with a pretty decent arch and like a lot of internal rotation. So the bar sitting and kind of using the outside of your hand to produce force is a lot more important the more internal rotation you have in your bench press setup. So just a little tip there. But yeah, I did that. Back downs move very easy, very efficiently. And now I'm going on a deadlift and probably hit somewhere around 500 pounds just for a triple. I think that should be pretty easy. Like, I haven't warmed up yet, so hopefully it doesn't feel too bad, but I definitely want a little redemption at the end of this block because I'm not happy with how I deadlifted at the meet. I think I definitely didn't take my time to pull enough slack. I think I probably even overestimated the strength I had for the day because it wasn't feeling how I normally felt. But we're gonna make deadlifts move today. Like, that, it's gonna move today, like, and I'm gonna make it happen. Deadlift, I am on the journey to be not necessarily a deadlift specialist, because I don't want to be a specialist, I just want to be a good lifter. But deadlifts moved very well today. I did the classic 50 kilo jump. Actually, no, it was 60 kilos today. I went straight from 3 reds to 4 reds and a white on each side. So, but yeah, it moved good. There's no reason for me to take anything in the middle from that. So I'm really excited. I think deadlifts are gonna definitely be something I PR at the end of this block. I think I'm gonna PR everything at the end of this block, but particularly deadlifts. I really just wanted to focus on my slack pull and just really being patient and in position. I think that's something I kind of got away from whenever I was at the competition. So just kind of dialing back in with that and kind of just making sure that, like, I'm in the most optimal position to pull and not like pulling and going back and being like, man, I could have pulled slack better. I could have been a little more patient. I'd rather just not have the strength for it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do like maybe like a quick little edit or something, because like I just have just some accessories. So I'm gonna just do that and then we're gonna get out of here. Okay guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and close out this video. Decided to do it outside, walking, getting my steps in, which I haven't been doing, but we're back on it. I wanted to mention really quickly at the end of this video that I mentioned earlier, just in the fact that like some of my goals have changed a little bit. Right now it seems like a lot of people who are in USAPL are talking about possibly going over to the IPF, and my goal is to be top 10, but I want to be top 10 where the competition is, so maybe I just got to try and be top 10 in both. I don't know, but that goal isn't as clear as it once was, so I just got to be a little bit better with it. But some of my other goals though, like my goal that I don't even know if I've shared before, but I want a total 2K at some point in the next like decade. So that goal is not going to change regardless of federation, but you know, it is what it is, man. We're just going to keep grinding, keep, you know, PRing, and the next time I step on the platform, which I have no meets planned right now, but that qualifying total is going to be, it's going to be child's play. So anyways, hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up down below. Really helps the channel grow. Also, don't forget to click the bell next to the subscription button so you get notifications for all my new videos. It's execution over excuses. Till next video, dismissed.
In this mansion, I'm a Carly Calkin. Paid in full, I'm a Kai Fife. Know your time, we just did dinner for 3 hours. Lying to me all night. Buying BMs, Benzes out of spite. Paid 100, ran a something light.